With courage I will face.
I will battle every day to claim my rightful place.
Come with me, the time is right. There's no better team.
Arm in arm, we'll win this fight. It's always been our dream.
It's you and me. I know it's our destiny.
Oh, you're my best friend in a world we must defend.
A heart so true, our courage will pull us through.
You teach me, and I'll teach you. Pokemon, gotta catch them all.
Gotta catch them all. You may now kiss the groom.
Hey, Brent, what are you up to today?
Whoa! Sex glasses!
We don't need any trouble. As long as you cooperate, this will go along just fine. I don't want to hurt you. I don't. But you know, you seem to know the answer to questions. Questions that keep me up at night. Questions that tear me apart. Questions like, what is the color blue? How do you lie? What does music sound like? What does it mean to love? Tell me Lois Lowry's the giver.
So, hi guys, in case you haven't figured it out by now, I'm Jacob. And that was a sketch about Lois Lowry's the giver.
Now, I know the giver and Gathering Blue, another book that takes place in the same universe as the giver. Both helped me grow up as a child.
Here's the problem. Many schools are banning the giver from reading lists and school libraries. And today, we take a stand against that.
So do yourself a favor and go visit your local library for a copy of The Giver or Gathering Blue. On us!
On us? Gee, Brent, I don't know about that. That sounds expensive.
Don't be stupid, Jacob. You can borrow books from the library for free.
And we'll see you in Elsewhere.
Body decomposed to millions of pieces of Captain Crunch would be that bad for you. But it turns out, well, it was.
Modern science has shown that crunchitization is one of the most dangerous processes your body can go through. The scientific definition of crunchitization is having your body decompose into its elementary cereal particles by spyglass. Solely for the purpose of exploring a fantasy realm. And it turns out that this is very carcinogenic.
I'm Private First Class Tommy, First Crunch Brigade. Quaker Oats Company.
Yeah.
I was just 10. 3 years after I stopped being able to go to Crunchland, that I went in for a routine doctor visit. And it was then that he noticed that my skin was getting yellower. We were hoping it was jaundice, but It was something much worse.
After Tommy, other crack kids started getting checked, and the evidence started to mount.
I'm Mark. I was one of the first crunch kids, and well, I got really into the stuff. I got addicted to crunchitization, and I tried being on the show as long as I could, but eventually get too old, and I tried getting my fix other ways. I did crack for a while, but just wasn't enough. Just doesn't give you the same rush as being crunchitized. It just same feeling of everything just being okay.
In addition to being highly carcinogenic, being crunchitized affects the dopamine receptors, creating strong withdrawal symptoms.
After I was kicked off the show, I tried searching for other sources of crunchitization. I went to all the boundaries of science I was experimented upon, and all it gave me was the ability to read minds. Now I know what you're thinking. That seems pretty cool, doesn't it? Well, it's not! I can't turn it off! I can't turn it
off! I swear, we at the Quaker Oats Company did not know that what we were doing was bad for the children. We just wanted to show that the world can be pretty great.
Honestly, we didn't know what we were doing to keep this up magical. We just thought we were giving them a dream. I'm not even a real captain. I was kicked out of the Naval Academy after turning my superior officer into crunch guard during a routine exercise. I just wanted to help the kids. I thought I wanted to be something special. I wanted to do something. Quaker was that opportunity. Oh, Cindy. I loved her mother. And now she won't even speak to me after what happened to Cindy. Science got rid of polio, but crunchitization brought it back. Oh, Cindy, why? Crunchitize me, Captain! Crunchitize me, Cindy!
My legs! My legs! What's happening? Nothing crunch more! Never crunch more! Take a moment to let everyone know that they should put on their 3D glasses now.
Yeah, we handed them out at the beginning. If you didn't get them, you should ask for someone because they're really important. So, does everyone who has a pair have them on right now?
Yeah!
Okay, great, because they're really important from now on.
Whoa!
Sometimes the good guy doesn't win.
They don't, Dad?
No, I mean, history's filled with examples of the good guy losing and the bad guy winning. Look at some of your favorite books. I mean, who wins in Green Eggs and Ham? Or The Very Hungry Caterpillar? Or Goodnight Moon?
The bad guy!
He'll be back from the bathroom soon.
Yeah. Can't wait to continue this game of 20 questions.
Okay, let's go. Your turn.
Yeah. Well,
is it mineral?
No.
Is it man-made?
No.
Is it bigger than a bread box?
Yeah, it is.
No, it's not. Trust me. I've seen it.
What do you mean? I haven't
said what it is yet. You haven't even guessed what it is yet. How do you know?
It's always dicks, Martin. It's always dicks.
Well, this time, I have the advantage. See, now it is my turn to pick the object. And I choose to use my Millennium Puzzle to transport us to the Shadow Realm. Here, I'll have the advantage. I'll be right back.
Going back to the bathroom. I left it. It's left in the bathroom.
It's like we didn't prepare for this well enough.
Didn't think that this would be such like.
I'm back with my Millennium Puzzle.
Is it an animal?
No.
Is it my Millennium Dick?
Shut up, Martin!
Shut up, Martin!
But yeah, it is.
Hey, Brent, you know I saw the other day?
Who?
Oh, no one. I was just trying to be cool.
DJ Shuffle in the house! Let's get this 2005 Brown start off right. I know what you want. I know what you want. You want some soulful R&B. That's what you guys want. Did I hear someone say slow it down? Slow it down! Well, I have no problem doing that. Hold up. That ain't slow. But you know, I guess with DJ Shuffle spinning the rings, you never know what you're gonna get. Let's see what comes up next.
Hey, you're no DJ. You're just sitting next on your iPod Shuffle.
Maybe I'm not. Maybe I'm not a DJ, but you know.
Yeah, you're not. That's what I'm saying.
But you know, in my day, people respected their DJs.
Well, you're
DJs
not.
DJs like DJ Skids, DJ Twist, DJ Reverse, DJ OJ, DJ Retroactive. Those guys were artists, man. But you know, it. Maybe I'm using an iPod Shuffle, but isn't an iPod Shuffle the greatest DJ of all?
No, that was DJ Reverse.
Maybe now we should have some DMX. Then maybe some Counting Crows. Finish it off with some, I don't know, Don Rue. Hold up. First though, I gotta get the Hungry Like a Wolf. Hungry Like a Wolf in my jam.
Yeah, it took me like 10 times to do that, DJ Shuffle.
Okay, hold on though. Right now, I'm saying DMX, Counting Crows, Da Rude. Ready for this? Woo!
Tom, I didn't do anything. How could I?
How did you? What?
belief. Maybe it's when the world least believes in DJs that I get most powerful. Maybe I control the shuffle.
That's impossible. No one controls the shuffle.
Nothing's impossible, Tom. And after a good amount of years and some training and the great immersion masters of the shuffle, I now am able to control the shuffle. So much so that it loses any concept of what is random and considers my thoughts as the only gateway to what to play next. Imagine it, Tom. All the chaos in this world, this galaxy, this universe, all controlled by my thoughts.
Whoa. Hey, DJ Shuffle?
Yeah?
Can you play Ignition?
I don't know, Tom! Can I?
No, break them off. Yeah.
It's the Jeffersons, dog. I don't think it's gonna make it. Go and get help. There are two types of pain in this world. The type of pain that makes you stronger and pointless suffering. I have no patience for the second kind. There are also three types of donuts in this world. Filled with jelly. Those with a hole punched in the middle. And those that are the whole of the former tower. I have no patience for crullers. There are three types of flowers in this world. Perennials, which last several years and keep coming back. Biennials, which last for 2 years and then die. And annuals, which are again similar to the former type, but instead last only a year. I have no patience for perennials, as even though they last longer, their brooms are less vibrant than the other two types. There are also three types of starting Pokemon in the first generation of the game. Charmander, a water type,
yeah.
And Bulbasaur.
Yeah.
Charmander, I choose you.
Yeah.
I have no patience for Bulbasaur. There are 99 kinds of Luftballons. There are also kinds of people in this world. Those that are intolerant of other people's cultures and the Dutch. I have no patience for the Dutch. There are 10 things I hate about you. And I cannot abide by any of them. got some news. I don't know if you think it's good news or bad news, but, I'm...
Oh my god!
Oh my god, do you remember?
Yeah, I got you a gift. I got you a gift just so you know, like, how I think of you and how I think of our relationship, you know?
You know, like, after we, like, went after, you know, I always sort of hoped maybe you thought of me as, like, more than a good friend, like, potentially.
No, just a...
Thanks, I guess. You know, Martin, lately you've been real. Yeah, Jed. I'm so impressed you managed to build a time machine with just your dad's old Aston Martin, an Allen wrench, and a 40 rack.
No, man. But seriously, we can only go to one time, and once we go, we can never go back. We can only go to the year 2069.
Nice!
Actually, we can go to any year with 69 in it.
Nice!
So where do you want to go first, Dad?
How about the future? The year 2069.
Nice!
Nice.
Let's go!
Whoa! We're here in the future in the year 2069. Nice!
Oh, this is a pretty rotten time period.
Ew, gross, you said period. Nice. Where are all the naked chicks? It's the year 2069. Nice, for Christ's sake. There should be naked chicks everywhere.
Yeah, dude, that is weird.
You know, maybe the future's not as cool as we thought it would be.
Maybe we have to go back.
Back to where it all started? The year 69.
Nice.
Whoa! Where are all the dinosaurs? Why are those two Roman dudes 69ing? Nice.
No, dude. Why are you saying nice about those two dudes? They're both dudes and they're both 69ing.
Nice. Like, here we are, instead of all this awesome dinosaur sex, all there is a bunch of guys from Gladiator 69. Nice.
Dude, you gotta stop saying nice when there's no dinosaurs and there's just those two Roman dudes 69ing. Nice.
Dude, you keep saying nice after we're talking about those Roman guys. Are you, like, homosexual or something? It's okay if you are, just tell me, dude.
No, dude. I like boobs.
Nice.
Those two Roman dudes 69ing sort of...
It's hard not to think of 69ing as something cool.
Nice.
Nice. Yeah, and they know what's up. Am I right, Roman bro?
You know, Beth, I really think we've learned something today.
You're right, and knowledge is power. Nice.
We still have one more place to go.
Way ahead of you, bro. I already dialed into the machine.
Ha ha ha!
even more beautiful than I imagined.
You are so right. We made it, brother.
The Big Bang. Nice!
Hey guys. We made Jacob and Brent explain y'all. A shout out to the 28th for being so great. And the t-shirt and the Prevo voices was also great. Collectively we are Jacob and Brent explain y'all. Individually we are Brent.
Jacob.
Yeah!